My name is Zuhir Chaudhry, and today's topic is about chemical contaminants in water. So we have point sources and non-point sources of pollution, and this is very important for all of us to understand in order to understand the chemical contaminants in the water. So what are point sources of water pollution? Point sources are those sources that can be easily identified, such as a specific drain pipe, a factory effluent, sewage treatment plant, an underground mine, or an oil tanker. So these are very specific places that we can clearly identify, such as the one shown in here, very clear point sources in here. The non-point sources, on the other hand, they're broad, diffuse areas. They're more difficult to identify and control, such as, for example, runoff from an urban street or agricultural runoff, pesticide being driven by the wind, etc. These are all non-point sources of water pollution, like pesticide that goes into the wind and then the rain catches it and then it falls with rain. That is a non-point source of pollution. Here are examples of point sources of water pollution, and here are non-point sources of water pollution. And very important that you spend time in understanding each one and why they are point sources and why they are non-point sources. For example, chemicals that get added to the road surfaces, such as salt or other de-icing agents during the winter time to melt the ice. This is a non-point source of water pollution because once you add it, it's everywhere, and then it can easily spread and contaminate the waterways very easily by rain or runoff, and the source is a non-point source. Same pesticide, herbicide, and fertilizer application in lawns, golf courses, and farmlands. Once you apply them, rain can wash away the excess, which eventually goes into the waterways, and this is a non-point source of water pollution. So here we can see chemicals that could be inorganic and organic that arise from either point source or non-point source of water pollution. So such as chemicals such as antimony, arsenic, asbestos, barium, beryllium, cadmium, chromium. These are all examples of inorganic chemicals that pollute the water. And they're also very harmful for human health. On the other hand, atrazine, benzene, carbon tetrachloride, DDT, and all of these chemicals in here, they are organic chemicals that contaminate the water and lead to adverse health effects and environmental effects. Because of their adverse health and environmental effect, they are regulated by US EPA, and you can find all the details by looking at this link. So, some quick concept check. Which of the following is a point source of water pollution? Leaking underground storage tank, effluent from a sewage treatment plant, leaking septic tank system, or all of the above? Yes, D. All of the above are point sources of water pollution because they can be clearly identified. Another concept check, true-false. Precipitation containing air pollutants is a non-point source of water pollution. Yes, true. Another concept check, true, false. Water becomes contaminated by both organic, such as DDT, dioxin, toluene, and inorganic chemicals, such as mercury, lead, and arsenic. True. That's all.